Hello, welcome back on my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to try out a new plugin, the ArcGeek Calculator plugin, which can be used to delineate automatically streams and catchments from digital elevation models. The developer of the plugin is Franz Puchakofreb, alias ArcGeek. Let's have a look at it. Let's go to the plugins manager and search for ArcGeek, and there we can find the plugin and click the install plugin button. It installs without any problem. And after installation, we can find the ArcGeek calculator in the plugins menu. It gives us three tools that are useful for stream and catchment delineation. Let's try stream network with order. In the dialog, we need to specify an input digital elevation model, a flow accumulation threshold, which is by default set to 5000. That's far too high for this area. So you probably need to calibrate this for your own study area. And then there are some smoothing parameters, the amount of smoothing iterations and the smooth offset. On the right side, you can read the help. I can save the result to a geopackage. I'll create a new geopackage and we're going to work on the ILTS catchment. We'll call it ILTS data and then stream network for the layer name. And then I run it. The plugin uses tools from GRASS, so probably if you get errors, you also need to install GRASS. When the calculation is finished, close the dialog, and the stream network layer has been added here. And let's have a look at the attribute table. There we can see that the Strahler orders and the Shreve orders are added to the attribute table. And it also has a field for the stream type. Now we can use the Strahler orders to style the river network using the interpolated line renderer. In the layer styling panel, choose simple line and change it to interpolated line. Under stroke width, choose varying width. And as a start value and end value, choose the Strahler field. Use the refresh button to scale it to the minimum and maximum value found in the attribute table. Here you can scale also the minimum and maximum width. Choose a blue color that shows up nicely in the map canvas. And here we see our nicely styled stream network. Now let's try one of the other tools. I'm going to try the Watershed Basin Delineation tool. It needs you to specify the input digital elevation model, and you can select a pore point in the map canvas. In this case, I want to delineate the ILTS catchment, and therefore I need to find the outlet somewhere over here. This is Passau, and I can simply click on the three dots and click on the point for which I want to specify the outflow point. You can change the smoothing iterations and smoothing offset if needed. I keep the defaults, and I save the result to our geopackage. And I choose for layer name ILTS Basin. Then I run the tool. When the calculation is finished and the basin layer has been added to the map canvas, we can zoom to the extent, and here we see the shape of our catchment. Now let's give it a style, and I'm going to use here the inverted polygon Shapeburst fill. Click on simple fill and change it to Shapeburst fill. For the first color, use a light gray. For the second color, keep it white but add some transparency. And we can set the distance of the shape burst and use some blur. And you can play a bit with the transparency to make it look better. Now it's also nice to see a line, so I use a simple line, make it a little thicker. For some reason, the clipping of the stream network, which the previous tool also should do, did not work. And I'm going to do that manually. So I'm clipping the stream network using the basin boundary and save the result also to our geopackage. I can simply copy the style and paste it to the clipped river network. And if I hide the original one, I can now see streams inside the catchment only. Let's try the last tool, Watershed Morphometric Analysis. I need to choose the basin layer, the stream network, and the Strahler field, and the digital elevation model. I keep the default decimal position, and what it will do, it will calculate morphometric parameters, and it will also output the hypsometric curve. When the calculation is done, you'll find in the log the path to a temporary folder where the results are stored. You can copy the path and paste it in the file explorer. If you scroll down, you'll find the results. An interesting one is the HTML file, which will give you the hypsometric curve in an interactive way in your browser. Besides the hypsometric curve of the catchment, it also shows model curves for young stage, mature stage, and old stage. And it will give you in which stage your catchment is, and in this case, that is the old stage. Besides the interactive graph, it will also give you a PNG file that you can use in reports. Another output of the tool is a point at the outlet. Let's use an SVG marker to style this. Make it a bit bigger and change the offset and the rotation. Open the attribute table to see the morphometric parameters that have been calculated, and this is quite a lot. It will give you the value of the parameter, the unit, and an interpretation. So at the end of this video, we can conclude that the plugin is very easy to install and that it is very capable to delineate your stream network and your catchment. But the most important feature that the plugin provides is the calculation of all these nice morphometric parameters, including an interpretation. Just be aware that for your own catchment, your own study area, you might need other algorithms that work better under those circumstances. For the rest, these automatic procedures can give you a very quick result. If you like these videos, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Looking forward to see you next time.